guys, it's Megan. Welcome back to my channel. So today's video, I wanted to do something a little different for me. I haven't really gone into much detail about this pregnancy. I've really been enjoying watching other people's pregnancy videos, and I'm like, why haven't I really done one? And I wasn't sure like what I really wanted to do. I've just mentioned in videos that I am pregnant and a little bit like what I want to do with the nursery and stuff, but I haven't actually talked about my pregnancy. And I realized that I'm doing things very differently for the most part than I did my first pregnancy, which was basically 10 years ago. My daughter's 9 now. I'm 35 now. I was 25 when I got pregnant with my daughter. So a lot has changed in 10 years and from that pregnancy to this pregnancy. I really made a conscious effort to change the way I did a lot of things this go around with this pregnancy than I did last time with the last pregnancy. I haven't really seen a lot of videos out there that talk about changes that were made in order to make yourself have a better second pregnancy. So I thought this video might be fun to do. Maybe it would help someone out there if they didn't have such a great first pregnancy and they were looking to get pregnant again and wanted some tips or advice or just hear about someone else's experience and having basically two totally different kinds of pregnancies. So hopefully this can maybe help someone. Also, if you've been pregnant twice, did you do anything different your first pregnancy to your second pregnancy? Did you have like very similar experiences? I would love to know your experience with it. So let me know in the comments below, and maybe that can also help someone too if they're looking for some pregnancy advice, encouragement, anything like that. I've got my little handy dandy notebook where I've written down all the things that I'm doing differently this pregnancy. And sorry if I sound out of breath. I am currently 27 weeks pregnant, so I've reached the third trimester, which is so crazy to me. The last time I like did an actual just official pregnancy video was basically announcing that I was pregnant, and I did that right as I went into my second trimester. So time has just gone by really fast. I will definitely say that's not something I'm doing differently because I don't really have control over that. But my goodness, this pregnancy as opposed to my first pregnancy, it's like night and day. My first pregnancy felt like it drug on forever. I think because the anticipation of being like a new mom, a first-time mom or a first-time parent, and then not having another kid that you're like juggling things already with, and like life and kid stuff and all that. Obviously, I didn't have that the first go around, so you were just much more focused on yourself and time can go by a lot slower. So this time has just really flown by, and yeah, it's crazy. Our little baby, if you didn't know, we don't know what we're having on purpose. We're not finding out the gender. We also didn't find out the gender the first go around with my daughter, and it was just exciting that way. Also, the name we keep a secret until we have the baby. Obviously, we have two different names, whether it's a girl or a boy, and my mom and my dad and my brother know, and that's it. No one else knows the name. We are eagerly awaiting this little one's arrival, but let's get into the things that I'm doing differently this pregnancy versus my last. Okay, in my first pregnancy, I was so guilty of saying, I'm eating for two. I'm just gonna go ahead and eat a little bit more of this, eat some of this, because I'm growing a baby. I'm eating for two. Oh my gosh, I used that so much. I definitely overate my first pregnancy like crazy. There were multiple reasons why I did. I'm a stress eater. My life was the first pregnancy was not a planned pregnancy. My husband and I, we like as a married couple, we were perfectly fine, but like financially we weren't in the best place. Career-wise, we weren't. He had just been laid off from a job, and I just kind of turned to food, and I used the excuse I'm eating for two to continue eating. And with eating for two, I wasn't like eating salads, like double portions. I was eating like pizza, fries, pasta, ice cream, all the things all the time. And yeah, this go around, I am not doing that. The first go around, I ended up gaining 85 pounds total, which is a lot. And I worked really hard to get all of it off in a pretty short amount of time, but it was quite a pain to do that, number one. Number two, it's not healthy for your body or your baby to just eat bad foods. If I would have gained that much weight but had been eating healthy, then that would have been a totally different story. But I know why I gained that much weight. I ate like crap that go around. And this time I just really wanted to fill my body with really healthy stuff. Now don't get me wrong, I still splurge every now and then. Like, I love chocolate chips when I'm pregnant. I don't know what it is, but chocolate chips is one of my cravings I had in my first pregnancy too. So I definitely do indulge, but I know when to stop this go around. And I've still gained weight, obviously. I talked to my doctor a lot about how much weight I gained the first pregnancy, and we came up with a number that we wanted to stick with this go around, that we wanted to kind of go between 25 and 35 pounds. I'm kind of right on track with that. I'm right around 20 pounds at this point. So I figure by the end, I probably will have gained like 30 pounds. That's the goal. I'd rather not go above that if I can help it. So I need to lay off of the chocolate chips a little bit. I just know overall, me eating like crap in the first pregnancy and letting myself gain all that weight, it just made me not feel good. You know, like when you eat crap, you usually feel like crap, and I just didn't want to feel like crap this pregnancy any more than I had to, any more than what was naturally gonna happen, getting like morning sickness and stuff like that, that I have dealt with. But I know at least I'm putting nutritious things in my body, so that is a major thing that I'm doing differently this go around. Kind of along that same lines, exercising. I didn't exercise a single time, I don't think, in my first pregnancy. I am so ashamed to say that, but I didn't. I used the excuse, oh, I'll start working out again after I have the baby, and there's no need for me to work out now, and you know, I can't really actually lose weight while I'm pregnant, you're not supposed to, so what's the point? And I just like justified it in my head, when realistically, all I was doing was hurting myself. So I know I would have felt better mentally and physically if I would have worked out even a little bit my first pregnancy. I didn't even go for walks, nothing. So this pregnancy, I have not worked out as much as I would like to have worked out, as much as I anticipated I was going to work out. But I've made sure that I'm at least doing a little bit. We have a Peloton, so I'll do a little bit on that sometimes. Sometimes I'll do a little bit on the elliptical we have. Sometimes it'll just like be walking. Sometimes I will literally just like do 30 squats or something in my bedroom while I'm watching TV. Just something to get my body moving. That has made me feel better. Obviously, I could be working out harder. I know you shouldn't be working out too hard when you're pregnant, but I definitely could be working out a little bit harder. But the fact that I'm working out at all compared to my last pregnancy, I am proud of. I feel like that has definitely helped me feel pretty good mentally and physically. It's helped me keep some weight off. Obviously, like I said, I've gained weight, but comparatively to my last go around, not at all the same. Another thing I'm doing differently from my first pregnancy is I am not obsessed with baby forums or expecting parents forums. Oh my gosh, well, the internet was not what it is now. I feel so old saying that. But 10 years ago, Instagram wasn't around and everything was just different. Facebook was very different and YouTube wasn't the way it is now. So I got addicted to reading and being on all these like forums with these expecting parents and parents that have already had children. I was constantly posting questions, reading stories, getting myself like all worked up over certain things of like, this person went through this and this person's going through that, and I would get myself all nervous. And I'm definitely not doing that this go around. I am still intrigued by other people's pregnancy stuff, especially with YouTube. Like, I like to look and see what other people are buying for their babies or using for their babies and different things like that, especially because it's so different than when I was pregnant the last time. There's so many different things out there. But I find that I'm not near as worried and stressed as I was the first go around, especially like reading other people's stories. I realize it doesn't do you any good to get yourself all worked up about other people's situations and worried and all that, and that's not good for the baby. So definitely off of the baby forums this time. Another thing I'm doing differently this go around with this pregnancy, as opposed to my last, is last time I was dead set on getting the epidural as soon as I could. I didn't want to feel the pain. I didn't want to go through that. And I was like all about the epidural. Well, nowadays I have watched, oh my gosh, I get so sucked into watching people's birth videos, or, you know, giving birth and all that on YouTube. So it's not like super graphic or anything. But I will find myself just sitting there watching and crying of all these different people that I don't even know who they are, and watching their experience and all of this. And oh my gosh, I've gotten so sucked into that stuff. But I love it. It's so sweet. But my husband will come in and be like, "What are you crying about now?" So watching a lot of those, I've seen a lot of people have really natural births, or natural up into a certain point, and obviously there's nothing wrong with getting an epidural. I'm all for an epidural, but I want to go into it this time trying to go natural for as long as I can, until like I can't take it any longer. Like, maybe I can go natural the whole time. I don't know, we'll see. I'm not gonna let myself feel bad if I decide to get an epidural, but I'm going into it with the mindset of I'm gonna try and do it as natural as I can for as long as I can, if that makes sense. That was definitely not even a thought the last go around. We'll see. Obviously things can change, and once that baby starts happening, you don't know what's gonna go on with your body and all that. Can't really plan for that stuff. So again, we'll see what happens, but my plan is to try and go natural for as long as I can, until I can't take it anymore. This one is so random, but this is something I'm definitely not doing this go around that I did last go around, and that is making a drastic change to my hair. I am notorious for changing up my hair during different things going on in my life. I've had my hair black, brown, red, pink, all the colors I've done, and I usually initially pull the trigger to change it when something is going on in my life, like something emotional or just something personal is going on. I usually, that's what I've noticed about myself. Whether I knowingly do it at the time or not, as I look back and look at the times that I've done all those things to my hair, or I've chopped it off, I've done something drastic to my hair at points like that in my life. So halfway through my first pregnancy, I decided I needed to dye my hair like a strawberry, like red strawberry blonde color. It definitely was more red than blonde. And I regret doing that. I had already gained so much weight, and I continued to gain so much weight. I wish I would have at least left my hair the natural blonde that it was. I just feel like, I don't know, I was trying to just escape. I just didn't feel great about myself, and I thought, well, maybe I'd feel better about myself if I changed my hair. But looking back on it, I look at the pictures, I'm like, why did I do that? I have always enjoyed changing my hair up, but I feel like I'd rather do it when I at least like the way I look other than that, if that makes any sense. I just feel like I got to the point where, because I gained so much weight and I changed my hair and I wasn't eating good, so I didn't feel good, I just didn't even look or feel like myself whatsoever. And I see that so much when I look back at pictures of that time. And this go around, I decided I am not going to change my hair up. My hair is much longer than it normally is, but it's not like drastically longer. I didn't just add extensions to it. It's grown out, and I'm not going to chop it off randomly and dye it a different color. I just want to keep things as much as my normal me, I guess, as possible. I'm hoping this go around, after I have the baby, that I will be excited to take pictures with the baby. With my daughter Lennon, I remember I just didn't ever really want to be in pictures with her. Like, I took some, but I just mostly took pictures of her. And so I don't have a ton of pictures, and especially I don't have a ton of pictures that are like nice pictures of me when my daughter was first born. This go around, I really want it to be different. I want to have lots of pictures of me with the baby, and lots of pictures of Lennon and the baby and me and my husband. And, you know, they don't have to be professional pictures, but where we, you know, at least try and take some good pictures. where we are dressed nice and, you know, just some ones that we might want to frame and put around our house and stuff like that. We really don't have any of that. We did like newborn pictures with Lennon and those were adorable, but like the pictures of me in them with her, I just was not a fan of. So hoping this time not doing something drastic with my hair will keep me feeling a little bit more like my normal self. So if you're thinking about doing something drastic with your hair mid-pregnancy, maybe don't do it. You might regret it. You might not. Go for it if you really want to. But I'm just telling you from my experience, I kind of regret it, and that's why I'm not going to be doing anything drastic with my hair this go around. Another thing I'm doing different is I'm not letting myself get completely freaked out about not having everything that we want or need right away and freaking out about, oh my gosh, I need how much of this and this and this and this. Because you really can get by with not that much. Having gone through it, I just realized I don't need as much as I think that I need or you may want. When I watch moms on YouTube that they're expecting their first child and they talk about the things that they're registering for, a lot of times I'm like, I don't think you need all that. But you know, that's just what it is when you're a first-time parent and you think that you need all this stuff. And sometimes maybe you do. I just know that we really didn't need that much stuff. A lot of the things I'm doing differently this pregnancy versus my last is just kind of focused on how I am letting myself or how I want myself to feel during this pregnancy. And I think that the way that you dress can affect the way that you feel. My first pregnancy, I did not try and like style myself or dress the bump, they say, or anything like that. I was just constantly in like leggings and a t-shirt or sweatpants and a t-shirt. Nothing fit me. I didn't want to go buy new clothes. I didn't have the money to go buy new clothes, and I just felt frumpy all the time. And this go around, I did not want to feel like that. I wanted to embrace my body the best that I could and just dress to feel good about myself, dress in a way that I liked and kind of find my pregnancy style. And I feel like I have kind of found my pregnancy style this go around. I wear a lot of like blazers or cardigans with little leggings or jeans and stuff like that. I also wear like bodycon dresses with little jackets over them or cardigans, stuff like that, bodycon skirts, different things that I feel like I feel good in. It still covers me up where I want to be covered, but accentuates the things that I don't mind showing off. Overall, I've just given myself a pregnancy style that I feel good about, and I think that has also helped me feel good this pregnancy. I feel cuter, and I think that makes a big difference. And you don't have to spend a lot of money to do it, honestly. Like this jacket I got at Goodwill for $4.50, I think it was. I've bought so much stuff at thrift stores this pregnancy because I obviously want to buy it in a bigger size. I want things to fit a little bit looser. I don't want to waste money on buying things just for this short amount of time. A lot of used stuff. Facebook Marketplace also has tons of maternity clothes on there. Like I said, Goodwill or thrift stores. That has definitely helped me be able to kind of get a pregnancy style going that I feel good about and not have to spend a ton of money in doing it. I definitely think trying to embrace and find your pregnancy style overall help you feel a little bit better while you're pregnant, because like it or not, your body's changing, things are changing, so trying to feel cute now and again is not a bad thing, and something I'm definitely enjoying doing this go around. Last pregnancy, I had no plan for after I gave birth. No plan for like food or anything like that, and I've watched so many people plan out their meals for like 2 weeks and do like these freezer meals and all this stuff, and just so much preparation happened before they went into labor so that they, you know, had a plan for after they came home with the baby, and it makes total sense. So I'm going to do that this go around. I'm going to plan out some meals, make sure we have certain things already in like our pantry and frozen and stuff like that to be able to get us through like the first week or two where we don't have to stress like, what are we gonna eat tonight and don't have to spend money ordering things, which always ends up costing so much more money to just get food delivered all the time. I mean, we might do that some, but I'd rather not rely on that, and I'd rather have a little bit of a better game plan going into it. So that is something I'm definitely going to do. If any of you guys have any good recommendations of freezer meals or things like that that are easy to do, let me know in the comments below. I would love that. The last thing I'm doing this go around being pregnant is not really what I'm doing while I'm pregnant, but is my goal and my plan to do after I have the baby, and that is not stressing out about trying to lose the weight immediately and get my body back to what it was. I focused on that so hardcore that I was dieting so hardcore in the beginning of after, you know, like I waited a few weeks, obviously, but I didn't wait too long. And once I started dieting and working out really hard, my milk supply dried up pretty quickly. And this go around, I'm going to really try to embrace the way that I am, let it come off naturally, you know, just not rush it. I don't want to be fixated on it. I don't want to be weighing myself all the time, trying to get down to a certain weight in X amount of time and all that. I want to try and keep my milk supply going for as long as I can and just really enjoy spending time with the baby and not worrying about what I look like and the size that I am, and just embrace that I am a mama that just had a baby and this is my body and it won't stay this way forever, and just let myself take it slow. That is the main thing, is just not making myself feel bad about it and letting myself take it slow. So I think that is pretty much everything that I'm doing differently this pregnancy versus my last. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything that you did differently in your first pregnancy versus your last, or if you're trying to get pregnant again or you are pregnant again, if there's anything that you are actively trying to do different and you want to do different in the future, let me know down below. I would love to hear. Overall, I'm just super, super grateful that I have a healthy baby growing inside of me and that I've been feeling pretty good and everything's been going well, and that's all you can really ask for. Hopefully you enjoyed the video and hearing some of the things that I went through might help you in the future, or you just found it interesting, because I find these kinds of videos super interesting. Either way, I hope you enjoyed and I thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.